Looking to add some fun into your task lists, gamification can add a sense of accomplishment and enjoyment to your daily tasks. In this video, we wanted to show you how to create a task list in Notion with pointed rewards so that you feel motivated to cross more to-dos off your list. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So let's first start with an empty open page, and let's go ahead and title the page. And here you can choose to add an icon if you wish. In this case, we'll look for something relating to games like this. Next, you can choose a cover photo by going to Add Cover, Change Cover, and then we can go ahead and click Unsplash for a stock image library. In this case, we're going to go with something minimal. And then we can go ahead and reposition it so that it looks the way we want. Save position. The next step we're going to take is to go to the top right-hand corner, three dots, and turn on Small Text Full Width. And this allows you to have more space on the page. In this case, we're going to have two columns here for the gamified task manager. So we're going to go ahead and type slash column to create two columns. On the left-hand side, we're going to be adding a monthly point tracker. So this is going to be in heading 3. So you can type slash heading 3 and monthly point tracker and then slash divider. On the other side, we're going to have our monthly stats and reward progress. So we're going to go ahead and type slash heading 3. And here we're going to have the monthly stats and reward progress. Then we're going to type enter and then slash divider. And then we can go ahead and move the divider over so that we have more space on the right hand side as opposed to the left hand side. And then finally, at the very bottom, we're going to have our task managers. We're going to go ahead and type slash heading 3 and then task list and then slash divider. And then we can go ahead and highlight both of these and then make sure that they are moved so that they're in this block here. So we have two columns and one large chunk at the bottom. So for this template, we only are going to have two main sections. So this is only going to use two Notion databases. And that means that in this case, we're not going to store the databases anywhere, but we'll just be using inline databases. So what that means is here we'll be typing slash table to create a table view database. And we'll do plus new table. And then we'll call this one task list. And just so that we can find it easier, we'll just put gamified. And for this task list, we'll create something very basic, but of course you're welcome to edit this as you wish, add more features as you wish. This is just a starting point. So this one is going to be the incomplete tasks. So we're going to go ahead and name this incomplete. And in order for it to be a task list, we're going to go ahead and click the plus sign here to add a checkbox. And we're going to move it over so that it can be checked off when it's done. And we'll rename this into done. Once you have that, you now have the checkbox, the name of the task, some tags if you wish. And then what we need to add are the due date. So we're going to go ahead and click the plus sign here, add a date, due date. Then what we're going to add is how many points each task is worth. So for this, we're going to choose a number property and we're going to name this points worth. And we can also go ahead and change the icon here to something more celebratory. And then out of the points worth, we're going to have a formula here for how many was actually awarded. So this is going to be a formula. And we're going to name this points awarded. And let's go ahead and choose something that looks maybe a calculator here that calculates the points awarded. And then later we're going to add the monthly stats so that you can actually see your rewards and progress. So now just so that we can get an idea of how this task list might work, we're going to add a few sample tasks. So for example, here we might have something like take out the garbage, and this is going to be a household task. So we can go ahead and create a tag for that. And then you would set a due date. So let's say that you want it to be due here. And you can set how many points it should be worth. So for the points worth, you have multiple options on how you can do this. In the case of this template, we're just going to add 10 points for each task. But of course, if a task is bigger, you could also assign yourself a larger amount of points. And then what we're going to do with the points awarded is that when you do finish this task, and then you can add an automated completion date, it's going to calculate how many points you get based on whether or not you completed it early, on time, or late. So if you complete your task after the due date, then you're going to have less points. If you completed the task on the due date, you're going to have the same amount of points. And if you complete it way before the deadline, you're going to have bonus points. So this way, it kind of gamifies the whole process that you want to get things done sooner rather than later. But of course, this is really based on how you want to set it up. So if you find that the due date is too soon, you can also change it yourself. But this is just to have fun. Just to add some more categories, let's go ahead and add a few more. So we have task two. Let's say that this is for work. Task three is for family. And for all of these here, we can also add different due dates. So we can put something like this. And then what we can do is also reorder this. So we're going to change the sort for the due date so that we see date ascending. So once we have that, let's also go ahead and set up the completion date. So we're going to click the plus sign here. And then what we can do is to select the date property. And we'll call this completion date. So there's two ways to use the completion date. You can either manually add them in when you finish the task, but ideally, since you click the done button, you might want to have this automated. And for that, you will need the plus plan in order to use the automation feature, but we'll just quickly show you how this works. So if we go ahead and click the lightning bolt icon, we can add a trigger, which is that when the done is checked, so if it's checked, then what we want to do is set the completion date to the date triggered, and then we can create. So just to test it out, if we click this as done, it's going to set the completion date. So now, as you can see, it set the completion date. And then now the next step we want to do is make sure the point awarded works correctly. So here is where it gets a little bit complicated, where you'll need to be adding a formula. And to calculate the point awarded, it's going to use several kinds of formulas. So let's say that it is checked off as done and the due date is empty. You just want to award the basic point. So for that, you want to do if done and empty due date. Then what we want to do is if that is true, we are going to go ahead and award the points worth. But if it's done, points worth plus, and then we're going to actually calculate the date between the due date and the completed date. So we're going to do date between, and then we're going to calculate the due date and the completed date. And then we want to see how many days it's been. And then if not, then we're just going to return 0, and then we can close it. So as you can see, now it's 8. So the reason it's 8 is because it was overdue. So you completed it on the 10th, but it's technically due on the 8th. So let's say that you completed it way earlier, then you get bonus points. So in this way, it's kind of a fun way to try to finish your task by the due date. And if you can finish it earlier, you get bonus points. And with this formula, if the due date is empty, so let's say that we clear this one, and it's still complete, it's going to award the points worth here. So it still works without the due date. So now let's actually go ahead and filter out those that are completed. So to do that, you're going to go to the filter here, and we're going to check that the done is unchecked, and then save for everyone. So only the incomplete tasks are going to show up here. So the next step in this is going to be to actually add the monthly stats to this. So we're going to go ahead and type slash gallery. So each of these boxes are going to represent the monthly stats, and it's also going to contain the reward that you set for yourself, or you can also ask someone else to set it for you so that it's a surprise. So let's go ahead and name this one monthly stats, and we're going to go ahead and go to the three dots here, and then go to layout, and then we're going to change the card preview to page cover. Inside each page, what we're going to do is to add a cover photo, which is going to be a gift box, and we'll edit the insides later. But for now, let's go ahead and name this one, for example, October 2024. We're going to remove this created property. So we're going to delete this property, and we're going to remove the tags. So the next thing we're going to do is connect this rewards to the task list. So we're going to go ahead and click plus add a property. And now we're going to look for relation. And what we want to do is to add the task list gamified. And we're going to show it on both task list and for this one. So now we have this empty, and we're going to go ahead and show this one as minimal. So once we have this one connected, we can actually do a roll up, which is going to roll up the information from this relation. So we're going to select the relation, and we're going to choose the property, which in this case is the points awarded. And we're going to calculate the sum. So this way you can see the total sum here, and we can name this one total points. The next thing that's necessary here is to have a goal. So we're going to add a number property here, which is going to be goal points. And we can go ahead and add something like a target. And this is where it's up to you how many points you want as a goal. So if each task is 10 points and in each month you want to complete, let's say, 20 tasks, that would be about 200 as your goal. And then what we can do is add a progress bar. So for this, we're going to add a formula. And this is going to be the progress. We're going to edit the formula. And for this, we're going to divide the total points by the goal points. And then what we need to do is actually add a round so that it rounds this fraction, and then times 100 divide by 100. And this is because the round unfortunately works in integers, so you have to sort of multiply it and then divide it again. And then what we can do is add a bar, and then for the number format we'll change it to percent. And then finally, we can add another property to show when this gift is unlocked. So we're going to go ahead and click plus, add a property. And this is also a formula. And here we're going to do edit. And what we are going to add here is if the progress, which is this, is greater than or equal to 1, which means that you have 100% completion, then we're going to do a style which formats text, and we're going to show unlocked. And we want it to be in green and in bold. But if it's not this, then we have the alternative, which is that it's locked. So we're going to go ahead and type style locked in red and in bold. And of course, you can style this in other ways if you want, but this is just what we added here. And we can save, and we can name this reward question mark. So now, just to test it out, we can start attaching our monthly tracker and reward progress to each of our tasks. So here we can choose October 2024. And when you tag it here, it's going to add it to this. And since you don't see anything now, you can go to the three dots here, go to properties, and then you can showcase the progress bar, and you can also showcase the reward. So you can see that it's locked. So let's say that we do finish some tasks, then it should raise the progress bar. So to do that, let's go ahead and also create a complete tab. So we're going to duplicate this one and call this one complete. And then we're going to filter the ones that are checked and save for everyone. So now if we go here and we check this off, you can see that it's 6%. And we can check more off, and it's increased the percentage. We can check here how many points we've earned. So here you can see 34 points, 200 is the goal points. This is the progress, and this is the reward. So now what we can do is to hide the database title so it looks a bit cleaner, as now it's starting to look better now. And what we can do is delete the ones which we don't have. So we're going to delete this one. You can also plan multiple months in ahead, so you have all your rewards lined up. And we can go ahead and hide this database title as well. So now what we're going to do is actually add the reward in. And for that, we're going to use something called a database template. So if we go to the arrow here and click plus new template, this is going to be a new month. And here we're going to slash heading 3. And this is going to be all of our tasks that are tagged by this month, slash divider, and slash linked view. And this is going to add a view of the task list. And we're going to show the incomplete. And let's go ahead and also add the complete. And then what we need to do is add an extra filter, which filters by the new month. So we're going to go ahead and filter it by new month, save for everyone. And then filter it by new month, monthly stats, new month, save for everyone. And then underneath here, we're going to have the reward. So we're going to type /heading3, reward, and then /divider. And this is where it gets fun. You can add a toggle. So we can put toggle and then add your reward here. So when this turns to unlocked, you can go ahead and open up the reward to see inside and then reward yourself for all the hard work and tasks you've completed. And something fun that could be great is to ask someone else to set your rewards for you so that you have something to look forward to that you don't know. So you could just ask them to put them in and then close the toggle. And it could be a really fun way to discover what it is that they rewarded you with. And if you want to hide these, you can always click like this. So let's go ahead and now click out and try this database template. We're going to also set this as a default so that it's always going to show this one. So if we click here, we can now choose the new month database template that we created, and we can see all of our tasks, our completed tasks, and you can add your reward here. So let's say that we are going to add an image. We're looking for some kind of mechanical keyboard. You can add something like this and then hide the image. So now if we click out, you can see the progress and that it's locked. When it is complete, it's going to look something like this. So let's go ahead and say that this was 34. You can see it's 100% and it's unlocked. So the final touch we're going to add is the monthly points tracker. So for this one, we're going to type /chart, and we're going to add a donut chart, and we're going to make it the task list, the gamified one. And what we want to show is the tags, and then each slice is going to represent the points awarded and the sum. So this way you can see which tasks are awarding you the most points in which categories. And this can be really fun as well. You can change the color here. So if it's colorful, it would look something like this. So that's the basics of creating a gamified task manager. You're more than welcome to add more features and more elements to this. This is just a very basic base to get started. You can also add different systems for your points, for example, into the formula. So this is another really great exercise if you're trying to learn Notion formulas as well. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know how your gamified task list turned out. If you're interested in more advanced task management templates, be sure to check out the links in the description. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.